everyone. This is Welcome to the Show.
We welcome you to Truist Park between the St. Louis Braves baseball.
I'm a brew. I'm lessons I'm written. Lord, thoughts fool. More than what I...
Charlie Morton is ready to go as he'll be on the Braves. Dan Plesac, what's next?
Well, Matt, this guy's properly nicknamed Ground Chuck because if he's on, you're going to see a steady diet of ground balls. Very important for Charlie Morton that his middle infielders on their toes. He should induce a lot of ground balls. Changed his arm angle a few years back after modeling after Hall of Famer Roy Halladay. Charlie Morton has been a very solid and dependable starter, and I expect him to pitch well in this one.
At the plate now, Dylan Carlson. First pitch to him and comes up empty. It's strike one. High fly ball out to center. Waiting on it is Heredia. One down. Chance to look at the starting nine for the visiting St. Louis Cardinals. Please add.
Well, Matt, they need Matt Carpenter to get back on track. Talk about struggling. He had less than 5 hits the entire last month. Whoa, like, that's like a hit a week. I mean, come on. When you wake up and fall out of bed, you're at least going to be able to get 1 hit a week. He has to do a lot better than that.
And that brings up Paul Goldschmidt. Strike one to start the at-bat. On its way, the 0-1 pitch offered at and missed is not going to get him as he swung. Well, when a stolen base is that close, it's interesting to check it out on ShowTrack. And as the numbers come in, you'll want to focus on the top speed. Really good, and it paid off there. Oh. 0-2 count. Here's the pitch. High and deep down the left field line.
Hey, I noticed pitcher's getting ahead right here. He's got the hitter down 0-2. But to this guy in the box, might want to just live on the corners a little bit more. You keep missing down the middle, something's not coming back.
Line to left. But pretty much right at the left fielder as he takes it in for the second out.
Batting four.
And that'll bring in Nolan Arenado. Opportunity for him here to pick up that runner from second with two away. From the stretch. Here's a shot to left field and deep. Look at this. Gone.
Love the homer in the top of the first inning. Give your pitcher a chance to kind of regroup and gather himself with an early lead.
In now, Tyler O'Neill.
The left fielder.
As he connects on the first pitch with a fly ball to center, Heredia gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. But the Cards do strike for two, both coming on. And here's Ronald Acuna Jr. now. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. He's set. Here it comes. Now the fastball is swung on and missed. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two. Set to deliver on nothing and two. Here it comes. And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone. And now here is Freddie Freeman.
The first baseman.
And he fouls this one off.
Freeman.
One out, nobody on. Well behind that fastball. It's a swinging strike.
This pitcher's bringing it with some high velo. You better get that front foot down early and get ready, or he's going to throw it right by you.
And he takes strike three called. Back-to-back strikeouts here to open the home first, two away. Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1.
Back-to-back strikeouts in the first right here, pitcher.
Oh, and meanwhile, this pitch rides too far in and winds up hitting him. Runner at first with two gone, and that'll bring up Abraham Almonte to hit next. No balls and one strike. Tying run at the plate, the 0-1. Way inside with that one, a pretty easy take there. And they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Boy, that's a jam shot right there.
We'll have to press pause as that strike three to retire the side. All set for the start of the inning, and now it'll be the catcher, Yadier Molina.
I'm interested to see how focused their ABs will be playing with this lead. I think this needs to be a little bit of a smell blood inning. Keep the fire rolling. I know it's early, but keep the pressure going. Swinging the bat's nice.
Hit high and deep to right center. Acuna giving chase. He tracks it down. A nice running play, and there's one away.
All right, the Atlanta Braves attack you on defense this way. And I'm locking in on second baseman Ozzie Albies right now. This guy is an elite defender. Came up as a shortstop through the minor leagues until he dislocated his elbow. Has since moved over to second base. And also, both sides of the plate, a switch hitter with this kind of swagger and this kind of defense doesn't come along often.
Popped him up. Albies is there for it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
Batting it, the shortstop. Hall.
Two down, no one on base, and that'll bring in the Illinois State product, Paul DeJong. A swing and a ball into the corner that hooks foul. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Fouled away. Bases are empty here with two men out. Hit hard up the middle. Oh, what a dive. He goes to first. It's there, and he's out. The defense on display on this beautiful diving stop at short. Back with more on a Thursday night following this. So stepping in is Austin Riley, as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 here to start the home half of the second. After it is O'Neill, but he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
He just tattoos this ball right here. Tried to sneak a fastball in on him? No way. Drives it to deep left center field gap, and that was a nice job to get the barrel around in time to score that baby up.
Swing and a looper to left. O'Neill comes in a few steps as he hauls it in for the first out. And the runner, not tagging, will retreat to second base.
The catcher.
He's ready. Here's the first pitch. Swing and a ground ball to third. This gets foul. It's 0-1. Riley leads off second with one gone in the inning. Swing and a miss. It's 0-2. Still no balls and two strikes. Fouled off. Now another 0-2. Lifts it into the air to shallow center. Center fielder on the run. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now. So a man at second here with two away. And up next will be Guillermo Heredia. Skied down the left field line. O'Neill waits on it. And he hauls it down in the corner. One left for Atlanta. They're still down. It's 2-0. Stepping in for the Cardinals, John Gant, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. Now the first pitch. This one's flared off to the right side, and that'll get down for a base hit.
Hey, this is perfect storm right here. This is how big innings start. You put a crooked number up on the board when the pitcher leads off an inning with a huge knock.
Hep brings in Tommy Edmund. Swung on and driven to right, and no doubt about it. And out of here, and I mean by plenty. That ball was crushed.
Well, in just a little more than two innings of work, he's given up two homers. Could be just one of those games for him. We'll see how much rope they give him. It's definitely getting shorter at the moment.
At the plate, Dylan Carlson. As the first pitch to him is swung on and missed for strike one. Flew out in his only at-bat so far. Behind 0-2 now.
All the makings of a big inning right here. One already left a yard, and the power hitters are coming up.
That's lifted the other way out to left. Almonte is right there as he puts it away. No problem for the first out.
The bat. The first baseman.
So next to hit is Paul Goldschmidt. Hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat.
Yeah, Matty, it's always a little frustrating when you square one up. You hit a solid line drive like he did, and all you have to show for it is a jog back to the dugout. That can get in your head for a little while.
Grounded down the third baseline. He's got it. On to Freeman at first, and there are two away now. So the bases are empty here with two gone. And in next, it'll be the perennial MVP candidate, third baseman Nolan Arenado.
He turned around that fastball and drove it out of the park in his previous at-bat. So this...
And we'll just leave it there as they make the play to end the inning. But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run home run. We played 2.5. It's now 4-0 St. Louis. Riding in is Charlie Morton. He'll get us going in the home half of inning number three. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out. Acuna digs in now. 0-for-1 here in the early going. Into the corner and slicing foul. 0-1 count. Here's the pitch. And he looks like he's toying with him here. It's 0-2.
He got a swing and a miss on that last pitch, but that's not the location he wants to live in against a hitter of this quality.
Ready with another 0-2. Still no balls and two strikes. Bases are empty, one man out. And it's fouled away.
You know, taking you inside the mind of a batter right here, you can't get in auto swing mode. You still have to control the strike zone.
Center fielder giving chase, and he tracks it down. A nice running play to record the second out.
The first baseman, number five.
Ready with the first pitch. Ready. Here it comes. Freddie Freeman stands in as he checks his swing here for strike one.
Man, this pitcher is on right now, pounding the zone, attacking these hitters. He's making it look easy.
Pulled toward right center field. Carlson is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Here is Tyler O'Neill, flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. Line drive, base hit down the line. And he'll scramble back to first safely.
Well, that's demoralizing right there. Nice job by the offensive player getting a head out, but that's got to upset you, thinking that ball might have went foul.
But you know what? You hear it all the time that the game, baseball, is a game of inches. One inch one way or the other could have been the difference between a foul ball and a base hit right over the third base bag.
On to first, and they get the double play. So the bases are empty with two gone now, and that'll bring up the sweet swinging Matt Carpenter. Out in front of it, strike one.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off speed. This guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Back.
Four runs, five hits, and no errors so far for the Redbirds. And he fouls this one off. The 0-2 one. Turned on, but it's wide of first and foul. Pulled hard, but it's foul down the first base side.
Seven foul balls in a row. Okay, come on now. This is getting a little ridiculous. Don't be shocked.
We'll leave it right there as he strikes out, and that ends the inning. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and standing in as the switch hitting second baseman, Ozzie Albies, 0-1 the count.
Albies
in there, and he's ahead 0-2 now.
I got the count 0-2.
Still no balls and two strikes.
There's another pitch for a strike, and this guy's really attacking hitters well tonight, being aggressive early on. And if he continues to throw strikes like he is, he's going to have a pretty good night.
Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Fouled away. The next 1-2 pitch. Fouled off. Another 1-2 delivery, and it's fouled away. Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. On pitch number 10 is the one that finally does it as he strikes out after a long battle here. So one out and nobody aboard, and that'll bring up Abraham Almonte to hit next. And he fouls this one off. Fouled away. One out, nobody on. Oh, and he struck him out as well, so he's carving right through the heart of this lineup as there are two away now.
Certainly not showing any signs of intimidation with middle of the order guys. That's back-to-back K's, and the 3 and 4 guys are harmlessly back in the dugout.
We'll attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. The 0-2 pitch. Fouled off.
Hey, having AB right here, I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
Trying to strike out the side. Here it is. Popped him up. DeJong over to his right. He handles it easily, and the inning is over. Nothing across here. This all ready to go in the top of the fifth, and that'll bring in the Illinois State product, Paul DeJong. This one's flared toward left center. Swanson ranging into the outfield. He can't get there as it falls in. On his way out to the mound now is the Atlanta skipper. And it looks as though that's going to be all for his starter here tonight. So he'll depart after working just four-plus innings, as this will not go down as a quality start, that's for sure. John Gant is at the plate now, and he's quickly behind 0-1. And that one cut a little too much, a ball and a strike. Tomlin typically throws a lot of strikes coming in out of the bullpen, resulting in low walk totals, although he has been snake bitten by the home run ball at times in the past.
What are the keys for the...
Swing and a liner toward the gap in left center. And that'll get down out there near the wall.
Hey, I've been impressed with this guy. Not only has he thrown the ball well, but now he's mixing in a base hit late in the game, giving his manager options. Whether or not he wants to pinch run, keep him in there, go to the relief.
Belted high and deep into right center. Ranging back is Heredia. On the warning track, he makes the catch. And a relay home. And the run will score on the sacrifice fly, so it's now a 5-0 game. Had a long way to go to make that running catch, and here it is again with the show track numbers. Took a great angle at it, showed nice closing speed, and ended up running close to 110 feet to finally bring it in. No doubt in efforts his teammates are appreciative of. Stepping in now, Dylan Carlson, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. Comes set and the 0-1, and a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Gant, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Pulled toward right center field. Acuna giving chase, but he's not going to get this one. It's into the gap. And that runner will hold up at second with two aboard now. And they'll get the ball back in quickly, holding him to a single.
Up next. I mean, he absolutely smoked that baseball right there, but was he watching it then?
Oh, that was a tough one right there. You know, as a hitter, you should be thinking extra bases coming out of the box. He definitely squared this one up. Pretty good chance, though, D-Ro. He should have been standing on second base with a double.
Riley is over now, and he's got it for route number two. Here's Nolan Arenado. He's set, and the pitch. And he takes a big swing at that one as this one's lifted high in the air and deep out to left field.
Gone!
So a three-run blast to straightaway left, his second home run of the game, as they've widened this lead to 8 now.
Second home run of the game right there. He is locked in at the plate. You hear so many of today's players talk about rhythm and timing. Well, he is perfectly on time in the heart of the zone.
Into the box, Tyler O'Neill. 1 for 2 in the ball game thus far. windup. Here comes the 0-1. Fooled with the curveball there, and it's strike two.
That's the first one of the day. If he's going to be on the lookout for that one, that's going to be a big pitch for him today.
Throw in time for the third out, but it certainly took a while as the inning is finally over. Here's Heidi Watney. Offering high to away center. Carlson is there, and he has it for the first out.
Now batting, catcher.
Stepping in next, William Contreras. He flew out in his last AB. Swing and a miss, strike one.
The difference between 0-1 and 1-0 is so monumental, and this guy has been on top of his game all day, attacking the zone and getting ahead of these hitters.
And a big curveball is in there for a called for two gone.
Man, this guy's on his game today, not only when he's throwing strikes, but how about the amount of strikeouts? What's even more impressive, no walks up to this point. So he's pounding that zone with strikes, and he's making these hitters swing the bat.
That'll bring in Guillermo Heredia now. And it's fouled away. Flew out in his only at-bat so far. Lofted in the air out toward right center. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Braves are set 2-3. They're on the short end of an 8-0 score. Welcome back to Truist Park just outside Atlanta as we send it down to check in with Heidi.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Cardinals to discuss his thoughts on his lineup so far. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Contrary to the usual strategy of working the count, they've been jumping all over the first pitch they're seeing, and that has translated into a bunch of hits. And more importantly, runs on the scoreboard.
All right, thanks, Heidi. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Liner towards second, and this will get over his glove as he couldn't quite get up all the way. It's a base hit.
Dan, count goes out the window with this batter right here. It doesn't matter if it's 0-2, 2-0, he's locked.
He has great bat to ball skills. There are some guys that just have a knack, D-Ro, of being able to get the barrel to the ball, and this is one of those guys.
No hits to this point. One and one. Popped him up. Swanson into shallow left. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out.
The batter, number 11.
Next to hit, Paul DeJong. He scored after knocking a single in his last at-bat. Now here's the first offering. To the left side, but it's well foul.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
Here's a fly ball, well hit. Acuna going back, but he can't get to this one. It's off the wall.
Boy, D-Row, there's a case of the outfield defense playing so deep that that ball looked like it was extra bases all the way, but they were able to cut it off.
Yeah, not too many times, I would agree. I'd love to hear your take on this as well. The no doubles defense, I kind of never understood it to begin with. I felt like the pitcher, if he can execute the game plan, could keep the ball in front of the outfielders, but right there, boy, I was wrong. That worked.
And he is out, retreating to third as they slap the tag on him. Standing in now, Tommy Edman. And he puts it on the ground to second. Albies picks it up. And the inning will end as they're unable to. Pablo is going to come off the bench as he'll be asked to lead off the bottom of inning number six. And he fouls this one off. Fouled away. Sandoval a 5'10" switch hitter. He's in the midst of his 14th major league season, so I guess you could say baseball has been good to him.
Yeah, Matty, no kidding right there. I'll tell you what, the grind to get to the big leagues is so hard. Guys just want, they just want to spend a month, a day in the big leagues. So to put yourself here for 12 years screams to your ability to adjust and be a great teammate.
Fouled off.
Hey, the guy on the mound is absolutely pounding his zone, and that's why he's been able to stay and pitch deep into this game.
Popped him up. And he'll stay with it to put it away as they get their man here for the second out.
The first baseman, number 5.
Next to hit is Freddie Freeman, 0-for-2 for him to this point. Now here's the first offering. Fastball just misses. That's ball one.
Hey, this guy's got to be pretty proud of what he's done so far. It's never easy to pitch on the road, but to have this kind of outing in a ballpark.
And the catcher grabs it to retire the side. Sean Newcomb comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one. Here's the first pitch.
Dylan Carlson.
Hit the other way out toward right field. Acuna's there for it. He's got it one away.
Up next,
digging in next, Paul Goldschmidt. He could really use a knock here. 0-for-3 in the game so far. On the ground to the right side. On to Freeman at first, and there are two away now. Nolan Arenado to the plate again and looking for home run number 3 in the ball game. His second coming back in the fifth. Hot shot down the line, and that'll get by and on through towards the wall. Throw into second. And he'll try to get back now, but it's not going to work. The throw. So up steps Ozzie Albies, batting left-handed here as he takes a look at strike one. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat. High in the air out towards shallow right. Here comes the right fielder, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first out.
The left fielder. Number 34, Abraham.
Yeah, always frustrating to go down looking. Everybody does it, though. You'll have a few ABs where you get completely fooled. Look for him to be on the attack early in the setback.
Here's the St. Louis manager now up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And he's looking to the bullpen here, so it would appear that's all for his starter tonight. So he'll leave here with one out in the seventh as he now hopes the bullpen can go ahead and get him the W.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
The next 0-2. And it's fouled away. No runs, just one hit, and no errors so far for Atlanta. And he fouls this one off. Fouled away. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one. Next up, Austin Riley flew out last time up.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. And it's another K. So back-to-back strikeout victims to... Ready to begin the eighth, and into bat next will be Tyler O'Neill. This is popped up, and there's the first out. Yadi Molina digging in now. He's got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. Strike one to start the at-bat. Bases are empty, one man out. High in the air into shallow left center. Almonte comes on and makes the catch in shallow left for out number 2. Digging in now will be Matt Carpenter. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. A bouncer to the left side, reined in. Throw in time, and the side is retired. And next will be Dansby Swanson digging in. He'll see what he can do leading off the home eighth.
Shortstop, Dansby.
And it's the outside corner. It's strike. New pitcher to tell you about, and it's a guy drafted number 6 overall out of North Carolina in 2006, the 6'6" lefty Andrew Miller. Here it comes, 0-2. Fastball called, strike 3, and there's the first out of the inning.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and it backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
William Contreras is in with one away now as he swings and misses here at strike 1. Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike.
That's a great take right there. Great pitch recognition to let that one go. Opposite-handed, that's coming across the plate. You might think you got a shot to stay inside that one.
The 1-2 is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
To the plate now, Guillermo Heredia. Popped him up. Goldschmidt waits on it. And that's the third out. All set to start the ninth in this one, and that'll bring in the Illinois State product, Paul DeJong. Fouled off. Checks his swing, but this will be strike 2 called. Protecting with 2 strikes, went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. And he checked his swing, but it's a strike 3 called, and that's the first out of the inning. So here now is the pitcher, Andrew Miller. First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike.
That's just too much velocity upstairs to get good wood on it. It's going to have to lower his sights.
Tried to pull that one back, but he couldn't. 2 now. Hard hit to the left side, but taken in out there at short. Had him played perfectly that time, and there are 2 gone now. Stepping in once again is Tommy Edman. He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. And he's able to get there on the long run, and he covered a lot of ground there. As Kevin Smith will get up off the bench to lead. Alex Reyes takes the mound here. Not a safe situation, of course, because of the big lead, but he'll try to finish it out nonetheless. And the move to the pinch hitter will not pan out as that's taken in for the first out.
The right fielder,
now to the plate, Ronald Acuna. No hits in 3 tries so far. He struck out once. No balls in 1 strike. Hanging curveball taken, though, for a second strike.
Your idea of working the count goes out the window. You're frustrated right now. Down 0-2. Gotta find a way to grind.
Again, another foul ball. One out, nobody on. And that is swung on and missed, and things are starting to look bleak here for the home nine. There are two away now.
The first baseman.
Boy, that's really disappointing for a guy that has wheels, right? All he wants to do is get on base and take advantage of the strength of his game, which is his speed. But with the strikeout right there, you can't get on first base.
Final strike for the Braves. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Man, they've already put the all-time winning streak record in their rearview mirrors. But with every win, it gets further and further away. We could say this now. This is one of the greatest teams in the history of baseball.
And 8-9.